I was fully prepared and I was prepared and I am prepared now. So how are you? Fine. Okay. First, we all are Ashtiwai. Majayo? Kakshitya Majayo? Then we will do first laughter therapy. Smile with me. Smile with me. Move it. Thank you very much. Here today, presentation subject. Today's presentation will be about Rohingya, the forgotten people, and I am Kazi Abdullah Mamun, delegation of Bangladesh RCY at Hans University, Korea. First, let me introduce you what is Rohingya and where they are from. You know, Burma, Myanmar? Okay, Myanmar. Here is the Myanmar. Burma. Hankuk Malo, Burma. And this part is called Arakan. It's the part of Burma, and this province called is Arakan. And the people living here, they are called Rakhine, they are called Rohingya, and when they cross this country and they come to Bangladesh, they become refugee. So we call Rohingya refugee. Why we call them Rohingya refugee? I will show you that. Listen. Okay. Their total population in Arakan Rohingyas, total population is approximately 1.5, and they speak Bengali, Arakanese, and their religion is Islam. So that's the people. You may remember the news, CNN, BBC, and all the international news media, they published this boatman's photos last year and this year too, the boatman's. So they have been living in the state of Arakan since the 8th century, but they haven't been recognized as citizens of the Union of Burma since Burmese independence in 1948. Instead, they are known as non-citizens, even though they born there, even though they are living there, but they are not the citizen. They are Uyghurin. Thagi Narayaswato, Thagi Uyghurin. Okay, facts about the Rohingya. The Burmese government endorsed the Burmese culture and the Buddhist faith for their national citizens, but the Rohingyas fall outside of this ideal criteria because they want to retain their own culture and the Muslim faith. As a result, the Rohingyas sidelined and marginalized have to live with their derogatory national status of non-citizens. So my country, where I have all the support, I have all the facilities from my government, but when I expect, and my friend also expecting, but when he become a Rohingya, he's from Arakan, he's Muslim, then what I am getting, he will not get that one. So again, he will be Uyghurin in this country. Uriga Uyghurin in the Han Samari Khadal Sisaya. But Kubundri Nara is the Khadal Sisaya. The Exodus, so these are both peoples between 1978. And in 1992, approximately 200,000 Rohingyas left Burma to escape the tyranny of the Burmese military. You know, Nasaka is a military, Kunin. So, in military, they also forced them, these people, they forced them, one person. Okay. So, they also forced them, they hit them, they killed them. So, because of that, the people, they are living from their own country. Most they moved to southern Bangladesh, where they remain as a refugee. The nearest border is there is a river, it's so renowned river in the world, that is Naf River. So it's so short, so they can cross the river and they can come to the Bangladesh. So that is the southern part of Bangladesh. And they are fine, they are coming, and they are coming here. My professor giving pressure here also on the stage. the situation in Bangladesh. In Bangladesh, the Rohingyas are faced with hardly any protection from their host country, a burden to densely populated country. So they are not getting support from their country. And again, Bangladesh also a populated country. So the Rohingyas are denied humanitarian aid, which forces them to turn to other means of income, such as drug trafficking. So when they come to Bangladesh, Bangladesh also doesn't have that much infrastructure that we can give you money, we can give you food, we can give you work. No, we don't. So what else? So they can't work as we do in Bangladesh. So the second option is smuggling. The second option is that drug trafficking. The second option is that something else which is not illegal. So they are doing in Bangladesh. That was a problem for us. As a citizen of Bangladesh, that was a problem for us. Human rights abuses against the Rohingya in Burma. In 1962, the Rohingyas were systematically denied of political, civil, economic, and social human rights. These affect their education and access to medication. Oh, they are not citizens, how they get the medication and the education too. Nowadays, the Rohingyas in Burma cannot commute from one village to another due to the security forces known as Nasaka, as I told you before. Who next one, sir? Yeah. So as the same way by the media also, we increase, we motivate the people to do that. Mali, let's go. Okay, just skip the door. Myanmar Red Cross also working for them, just to go forward. Myanmar Red Cross is working for what I told is I am brown, my friend is white, you are yellow. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 Red Cross word and we are friends. Badayo, bridge with us.